Tonight, as I indicated, we are going to be having a civil society actor as guest in this edition of the news, Mr. Lapana Tasha. Mama, good evening to you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight on Talking Point.
Good evening, Meme. I'm very grateful to be with you.
We thank you so much for coming. You have written an article indicating or stating that you could possibly propose solutions to the current socio-political crisis in Cameroon. Can you tell us more about that?
Cameroon is a country blessed by God, but have been corrupted and embezzled by many people, wicked, as I call them. And then since 2006, I've been putting things in order, not thinking that something of this nature will come. I was facing the corruption, but finally I found myself without publishing it in the midst of other Anglophone problems. So I came up with a proposal saying concerning the Anglophone problems. The first, I have two proposals. The first was to the government, in which I never have the opportunity to send it out to the appropriate quarter. And then the second, now because of the level and the tension in the two Anglophone regions, I came up with a proposal that it is our country. Cameroon is our country, and we cannot sit there and then a group of people spoil the country while we are there hoping and looking forward for people who are killing us to propose a solution to it. We are the one. The two people are fighting, the Anglophones are fighting, and the government. And then within, in between, there are people that are called the neutral people that are not involved in it, because not all the territory that are involved in the crisis. And then these people I propose to, and then I'm writing an article to all those I consider, and then I wish them to also propose to me those who are credible, who are trustworthy, who are competent to handle this nation, because there are people in this nation that can handle the problems. Those that the Anglophones trust in it, because the government cannot stand anywhere now to say something or to call for any sincere
and
or any dialogue.
Especially in the
so I propose, my first proposal goes to the men of God, and then some Cameroonians that are trustworthy, to create a neutral body in these nations and call the government, not waiting for the government, because any organization or any person going out to solve the Anglophone problem that have any links with the government, that person cannot be trusted.
Before we talk about the role of the church, because the International Crisis Group actually cited the Kali Church as the only neutral and credible body that can be able to handle the crisis, you said that the President of the Republic did not respond immediately as soon as the crisis started or escalated in November 2016. That is why we are where we are. And today you are talking about the solution when things are the way they are in the northwest and the southwest regions of the country. Do you think that a solution is possible at this point in time?
The solution is very possible. Even with the government, even with the president, the solution can. Because the issue started, seen on the 8th of December 2016, up to today. The president have not maybe organized even a praise to even say a word concerning the Anglophone problems. And then now I consider that there is in any situation there is an opportunity.
He has addressed the Anglophone concerning problem in his end of year speeches. He talked about it in November. Is that not enough?
No, that is, you cannot take an opportunity for a different occasion to address a different occasion to address a situation that is touching lives. Because the Anglophone problem have pushed many of our brothers, many of our sisters are begging, grandparents, those who cannot even see, are begging along the street in Nigeria. Some are in the forest, they don't have a house to stay. But the government and the president is there, and he has never, maybe a day, say, I want to address the Anglophone problem in particular. For me, I propose that to him, it is an opportunity for him to see those that have been supporting him, have been giving him motion of support that he has never seen. He has neglected the nation because staying in power for 35 years. It is an opportunity for you to stand as the best person to explain that nation or the corner of the nation.
Do you think that addressing the problem is sufficient enough?
Now, like this, addressing the problem, talking about the problem is not. For me, I propose that the government or the president of the Republic of Cameroon should go up. Because why quite remember in history, they talk about the problem that was in the KNDP. When Fonjan was to move to Yaounde as vice president, Amadou Ahidjo and Augustine Gunja, there was a problem between them. And then Ahidjo did not remain in Yaounde. He went down to Buya to read for himself the political temperature. And then it is an opportunity for the president of the republic to go down, not to Buya, not to Bamenda, but to those villages that have been burnt down, and see for himself, to go to Nigeria and see for himself his people that are there. That is my cry, and that is the only, if the president carry his feet or all the government and went down to and go down to Buya, to those areas, this problem will have a solution.
Like you said, the crisis is escalating. Since 2016, at this point in time, several villages have been razed completely. Many people are homeless. Several English-speaking Cameroonians in neighboring Nigeria, others displaced even within the national territory. But the government has not reacted to that. What does that mean, looking at...
Looking at that, to me, is that the government of Cameroon, through our life, have been solving problems in this nation in a political way. They believe that when you remain hungry and then you see food, you remain silent. But that is how they wanted to tackle the Anglophone problems. But they went that way, it failed. And then they still believe in that. Villages are down, people are, the problem is, because we are talking now, every day we are hearing about new villages that have been burnt down. Just now we are hearing about the Mumu divisions. And then we don't know, here in Douala, something can happen. We are about to celebrate the national unity. That is the marriage, the wedding that came between the Anglophones and the Francophones. And then we, at this particular period, we are, what are we celebrating? I'm saying that all those villages, we cannot be celebrating. Why others are not, they don't even have food to eat. Why others are in pain? Why others are crying? Why others don't have even opportunity to bury their lost one? So I look into it, that all the government have to do something. If the government cannot do something, we will not remain silent. And that is why I propose that there should be a neutral body that is free from government.
And that neutral body, according to you, should be the church.
It should be the church, and there are some people I talk about. I have been following up your programs here. I see people like Akun John, many of them.
Giving proposals.
Davison, those are people that they have ideas. But the idea, there is no way to bring it up. But if those people gather themselves together, the Kali Church cannot do it alone.
But the Kali Church has been holding meetings. Their series of meetings, they have been providing solutions to the Anglophone crisis. Do you think that their solutions, their proposed solutions, can be listened to?
The solution I'm talking about is not a writing to the government for the government to respond. It is to take over power. Take over power, take a neutral body that we are out to solve this problem until this problem is solved before the government will do, military should stop harassing people. And for now, we have to look into it. They go into the Anglophone region, they select those that are very concerned with their problems, the pillar of the leaders of the Anglophone problems, and then bring them out, call the government. The government should come.
Are you saying that with the current regime, the crisis cannot be solved?
With the current regime, they cannot solve. They started the problems, and then there is no way up to now, if they cannot solve the problem, I don't believe they can solve the problem.
What equally gives you the confidence that your proposal can push through?
What gives the confidence I have? Is that when, for example, I take example Equinoxe, when you sit somewhere and you talk about, I listen to news about this Anglophone problem, they first of all ask you why, which station. When you mention some kind of station, they just say but when you mention Equinoxe, people say the Anglophone themselves, they say okay, they can listen to. When now with this Anglophone problems, there are people that when, if they say okay, we have something to say. And then the Anglophone, looking through those people, discover that those people have not been influenced by the government. They were listening to them. But what I'm saying here is, the Catholic Church, they have proposed that, they have been praying, they have been proposing to the government, but they are waiting for the government. Two people cannot be fighting. And then you want somebody amongst the two to come up with a solution. No, there must be somebody, neutral person. The government is the elderly person to the Anglophone people. And then the government as the elderly person cannot solve the problem up to this particular period. It means that they need somebody
to stand in the beside. That is why the international community too is being called, is being urged to look into the crisis. On several occasions, we have seen the United Nations reacting. We have equally seen some international dignitaries talking about the Anglophone crisis. The most recent action is that of Akeremone that has actually written to the United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, calling on the UN scribe to look into the situation in the two Anglophone regions of the country. Do you think that it can yield some fruits?
For me, we are more than 50 years old as we gain the independence of this nation. And then up to this particular period, we cannot handle our problems alone. The international body, even the Commonwealth Secretary General came to Cameroon, passing through Yaoundé. All the international body, if you listen to what the America U.S. ambassador said yesterday, that they are waiting for somebody to invite them. And then who is to invite them? The government. If the government invited, the government have to give them the agenda to follow. So all those international bodies, I am proposing that the government, we are neutral, we have not yet been touched by the problems, should gather ourselves, those trustworthy people, should gather themselves together. Those churches.
Without the actors involved,
yes,
without the government.
Without the government involved, without the
activists
involved, call them together and say this is how it is, and then give them a time period.
Thank you so much, Mr. Lapanatasha Mama, for joining us tonight on Talking Point. We hope to have you some other time again.
I'm grateful.
Thank you so much. An actor of the civil society there, giving solutions to the current socio-political crisis rocking the two Anglophone regions of Cameroon. They're bringing us to the end of this edition of the Primetime Newscast on Equinoxe Television.